Welcome back to our Getting Started tutorial series. In our previous video, we covered the basics of instruments in FMOD Studio. Today, we'll be covering how to trigger those instruments dynamically using the logic tracks. Logic tracks in FMOD Studio are used to change the behavior of the playback position in timeline sheets. The loop region we created in video 2 is an example of one of the region types you can use. We discussed previously that the playback position moves from left to right in a timeline sheet, like standard DAW playback. Using the logic tracks in a timeline sheet, you can change this behavior to make the playback position return to a previous point on the timeline sheet, pause its position, or jump it to a different position entirely. We call these types of behavioral changes timeline logic. You can add multiple types of timeline logic to logic tracks. These can be grouped into regions and markers. Regions cover a section of time between two points. For example, you could have a region going from bar 1 through to bar 8 in the timeline sheet, or from 3 to 10 seconds. A common example of regions would be to loop a piece of music. Markers specify a certain point you can move the playback position to, such as bar 4 or 5 seconds. A common example of using markers would be at the end of a section in a music track. To showcase these features, we're going to use a music file. We have this single track, but we want to dynamically decide what part of the music plays using a parameter. To get started, let's create an event to play our music file. So we go to the Events tab, right-click, select New Event, and call this event Music. We can then left or right click in the sheet's workspace area and select Add Timeline Sheet to add a timeline sheet. We don't need any special functionality from our instrument this time, so the default single instrument will be perfect. FMOD Studio will automatically make a single instrument for us when we drag the music file onto the timeline sheet. To start with, let's make the creation of our regions easier by ensuring we're set to Beats View by clicking here, and setting our timeline sheet to a specific tempo. By setting the tempo in the timeline sheet, you're setting the speed at which the playback position plays through a given bar. This track is played at 150 beats per minute and is in 4/4 time, so we want to set our timeline to the same. We can use a tempo marker for this by right-clicking in the logic track of this timeline sheet and selecting Tempo Marker. To keep things neat, let's move the tempo marker to the start of the timeline sheet. To edit a tempo marker, you just need to double-click the marker. FMOD Studio has automatically highlighted the tempo for us, ready to edit. Just type 150 for 150 and press Enter. You can then see the timeline has been adjusted to accommodate the new tempo. So we can see the individual bars easier, let's zoom in by either left-clicking and dragging on the right side of the sheet overview here, or by simply holding the Alt key on Windows or Option key on Mac and using your mouse wheel. Let's zoom back out using either the sheet overview or the mouse wheel again so that we can see the whole music file. To be able to control the playback of different sections in the music, we need to first identify where those sections start, then tell FMOD Studio where those are. We can use the destination markers for this. If we right-click in the logic track and select Destination Marker, FMOD Studio will create one at the closest beat division to the cursor. To rename a destination marker, simply double-click, type the name, and press Enter. Let's call this one Start. We can reposition this marker by left-clicking and holding, and then dragging it to our desired position. As this marker is called Start, we should move it to the start of the track. Seeing as this track actually has a little ramp up into the first beat, we should create another destination marker for the first beat. So we create another destination marker and call this one Section A. You can see that the first beat of the music actually starts at bar 2. So let's reposition our new destination marker there. Let's repeat this process a few times by adding more destination markers in at the various changes in our track. After adding all our destination markers in, we now have Section A, Section B, and Section C. We can also tell FMOD Studio to loop each individual section by adding loop regions. We'll follow the same procedure as video 2 by right-clicking in the logic track and selecting Add Loop Region. Let's add a loop region and resize them to cover a section each by clicking and dragging the left and right side of the regions. If we now press play at the end of section A, the playback position will return to the start of section A rather than progressing through the music track. Now that we have our three main sections marked out, we need to add the ability to move between the different sections. A transition marker is one way to do this. So let's create a transition marker by right-clicking in the logic track and select Add Transition. While the transition marker is selected, you can see its transition conditions component displayed in the deck. We'll cover this in more detail as the video continues, but for now, just focus on the destination drop-down menu. By selecting this drop-down menu and hovering over markers, you can see that our four destination markers we set up are in this list. When you select one of these markers, you create a type of conditional logic that tells the playback position to change its behavior. In this case, we're telling the playback position that when it passes the transition marker, instead of continuing normally, it needs to jump directly to the destination marker specified. Let's test this functionality by selecting Section B in the Destination drop-down menu and pressing Play. Now, however, the transition marker causes the playback position to jump to the next section every time it passes, meaning we can never loop Section A. This is where trigger conditions come in. Trigger conditions are a type of logic statement that dictate whether or not something will trigger. You can think of this like FMOD Studio is asking a question every time the playback position passes the marker. In this case, we want FMOD Studio to ask, is a specific parameter set to a certain number? If the answer is yes, then we want this transition to happen. If not, then we don't want the transition to happen. To set this up, first we'll need to set up a parameter to control our logic, which the game engine can then adjust during gameplay. From the transition conditions component, select Add Condition, then hover over Add Parameter Condition. From here, you can select any parameters that you've created so far. As this is a new project, we don't have any yet. We can easily create one by selecting New Parameter. We can leave everything as is again, but rename this parameter to music_transition. Then select OK to create the parameter. As we created this parameter directly from the transition conditions component, you can see FMOD Studio has automatically added it under the list of conditions. A trigger condition simply checks whether or not a parameter is within a specified value whenever the marker or region is triggered. The value or values within the green range meter are what FMOD Studio checks. In our case, we only want the music to transition when the music transition parameter is set to 1. To create this logic, we just need to drag the left side of the green range indicator to the right, so that the range displays 1.0 to 1.0. Now, if we move our music transition parameter by left-clicking and dragging it up, you can see that when the parameter is set to 1, the music transition condition changes to a lighter color, indicating that it's active. When the parameter is any value except 1, however, it returns to gray, indicating that it's inactive. If we now set our music transition parameter to 0 and press play near our transition marker, the playback position passes the marker and continues normally. However, if we set the music transition parameter to 1 and press play, the playback position reaches the transition marker and then jumps to section B. Although transition markers are great for manipulating the playback position at specific points, Let's say we want the playback position to be able to jump to section B at any point during section A. We mentioned earlier that regions in the logic track cover an entire section of the timeline between two points. This sounds like what we're after. Looking through the options in the logic track, you can see the transition region. This is exactly what we want. A transition region functions the same way as a transition marker in terms of conditions and parameters, but the difference is that it covers an entire section of the timeline sheet. If we select Add Transition Region, you can see there's now a green region in our logic track that looks similar to the loop region we added in video 2. We can resize this region by left-clicking and dragging the left side of the transition region to our destination marker called Section A, then set the right side of our transition region by dragging the right side to our destination marker called Section B. This has covered the entire time between Section A and Section B in our transition region. We can now replicate the steps we completed in the transition marker to set up the same trigger condition by selecting our timeline region, navigating to the transition conditions component in the deck, and selecting Add Condition, Add Parameter Condition, and selecting the parameter Music Transition. Then we can set the values that cause this transition to happen again by dragging the left side of the green range indicator like this. Don't forget to set your destination under the destination drop-down menu as well. Now, if we press play, you can see the playback position moves normally. Then, if the transition conditions are met at any point during this region, the playback position will jump to section B. You might have noticed, however, the transition wasn't very fluid. This is because the transition happened as soon as the transition conditions were met, rather than waiting for the next bar and transitioning in time with the current music file. To fix that, we can select our transition region and navigate to the quantization section of the transition conditions component in the deck. Here, you can see there's various musical divisions from 8 bars all the way down to an 1/8th note. These values indicate the interval that a transition condition will be checked as to whether or not its conditions are met. You could think of them as individual transition markers being added automatically based on the division that you choose. If we select 1 under the bars category, the transition region will wait until the start of the next bar to perform the transition, given that its transition conditions are met. If we press play now and change the parameter again, you can see the transition waits until the start of the next bar, making it much more musical and fluid. Once you get used to these concepts, you can use them to create dynamic music transitions even from a single music file. You can find more advanced examples of transition regions in our example project or in our advanced video playlist. Our next video will cover parameters in more detail, giving you even more control over your dynamic audio. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell to keep up to date with all our upcoming videos.